I'm arguing here that political correctness has helped drive a populist backlash that is not good for the country. I don't think the populist backlash is great for the country, but I think the political correctness is even worse for the country. And so what we've seen is a toxicity in politics that is led by an attempt to quash debate, not just about terrible, horrible, no good, very bad ideas, but about mainstream ideas. I'm talking about mainstream scientific investigation is being forcibly quashed by the forces of political correctness on the left. Today's example is particularly insane. It comes courtesy of Brown University. So Brown University has now pulled down a news story on a study conducted by one of its own researchers. The study focused on what it described as rapid onset gender dysphoria. Okay, gender dysphoria, gender identity disorder, transgenderism, that was not present in early youth. Okay, so this wasn't a kid who was three and said, I'm a little boy when it was a little girl. Instead, it was gender dysphoria that manifested within days or weeks in teens and young adults. In other words, it's become trendy in some areas of the world for people to declare themselves transgender. And you've seen this in the statistics. The number of people in Britain who have reported themselves to basically institutes that help deal with transgenderism has doubled in the course of 1 year. Don't tell me that evolution radically shifted in the course of 1 year, or that there were this many people who are transgender who just realized it in the last year, that they'd felt this way since they were three, but now that they watched it on TV, they finally realized that this was happening. As I say, when it comes to human behavior, a large component of human behavior is indeed biological, and a huge component of human behavior is biological responses to environment. Environment does matter when it comes to all sorts of behavior. It's so funny, the left will acknowledge this when it comes to things like IQ, that IQ is indeed responsive to a certain extent to environment. They'll deny that IQ even exists with regard to biology, which is bizarre, or at least they'll make the case that biological studies with regard to IQ should not be done because we can't look at the biology of IQ, but we certainly should pretend that all sexual behavior is innately biological, and therefore, if you have a drive toward a sexual behavior, this means that you were born this way, right? This is the Lady Gaga case about biology. The reality is that human behavior is quite malleable, particularly in the sexual arena. And one of the things that has happened with regard to transgenderism is as it becomes more prominent in the media, there are more and more people who are being confused. There are more and more people who believe that because they feel like outsiders, this must mean that they actually are outsiders in their own body.